Do you sometimes have to pay a fee just to pay a vendor's bill? Well, this video will show you how to record that in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Usually there is no fee just to pay a vendor's bill. But if there is, then usually the vendor pays the fee to the financial institution that processes the payment. In rare cases, however, the one paying the bill has to pay the fee to process the payment. And that's especially true when you pay a vendor from your own preferred payment platform, such as PayPal or some other institution that you want to pay from. So what's the problem? Well, there's only one payment recorded in your bank account for both the fee and the bill you are paying. Therefore, you must only record in your QuickBooks records one and only one payment in the amount of the bill plus the fee. This is because you must reconcile your QuickBooks records with your bank records and they must match. However, the fee is a different expense than the expense that's listed on the bill. So what do you do? Well, the only real solution is to do the following. On the day that you pay, you first enter a separate bill only for the transaction fee. The bill date must be the date that you pay. This bill will record the bank fee expense of the processing of the payment. You must put the vendor you are paying as the vendor on the bill, not the pay platform that gets it. For example, if you're paying Verizon and you have to make a payment fee, the bill you enter for the payment fee should have the vendor as Verizon, not the vendor as Chase Bank or PayPal or anyone else. The bill for the fee has to be entered as the same vendor as the original bill that you're paying. This way, you can pay both bills by recording only one transaction into the QuickBooks Online Pay Bills window, the way it would look on your statement when you reconcile. For example, let's imagine on April 7th, we paid bill number 3210 from Verizon with an additional $15 payment fee. We must enter a bill for $15 and the bill date must be April 7th. The expense on this new bill should be bank fees unless you set aside a specific expense specifically for payment fees to vendors. You can put an explanation and the name of the financial institution in either the memo or the description field. And then you pay both bills with one payment on the same day, April 7th, with one entry. And that's what gets you to match your bank when you do your bank reconciliation later. Let's take a look at how to record this particular situation. We go to the column where it says bill. And we make sure we put the date April 7th of 2017, because that's where we are in our little story. And the vendor is Verizon, because that's whom we're paying. Now, of course, the expense will be bank fees, again, unless you set aside a specific expense. The amount is $15 in this example. And of course, you should put in the description the reason why you have this bill. be as clear as you can, and now this bill will record the $15 fee at the moment that you pay. We click Save and Close, and now we're ready to pay both bills at once and have everything recorded in one entry the way it would look on your bank statement. This time we go down to the Pay Bills window, and again, make sure it says April 7th of 2017. And this time, I guess we'll have to click Filter and do this. We want to see all dates, and we want to see only Verizon. So you should get comfortable with the Filter tab here in the Pay Bills window. And now we see all the bills to Verizon. Now, we are paying the full amount of bill 3210, but we are also paying an additional $15 fee. The amount that's coming out of our bank account with one entry on April 7th is this $895. That's why we have to check them both this way as being paid to the same vendor, Verizon. Now, we click Save and Close, and everything is exactly as it should be. The bank account has one entry that decreased by the whole amount, just like it'll show on the bank statement. The extra fee is recorded as a bank fee in the correct amount as of the actual date that we incurred that expense, and the original bill is paid. And this is the way to record that situation. One final note, you should not change the vendor's bill by adding the payment fee expense. If you do that, QuickBooks Online will record the expense as of the bill date, not the payment date. And that's not correct. You do not have the payment fee until the day of payment. That's the wrong way to do it, so do it the right way, the way you just learned in this video.